हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट ओस्टियोमलासिया. ओके, सो लेट्स गो, वी विल स्टार्ट अवर टुडेस क्लास. व्हाट इज ओस्टियोमलासिया? ओस्टियोमलासिया मीन्स सॉफ्ट बोन ऑफ एन डेवलप बिकॉज ऑफ विटामिन डी डेफिशिएंसी. इट इज अकर बाय द विटामिन डी डेफिशिएंसी. इट इज रिलेटेड टू बोन डिसऑर्डर एंड दिस कंडीशन सॉफ्ट बोन इज अफेक्टेड. It is called osteomalacia. And if children are affected by osteomalacia, it is that condition we call rickets. Student, if you heard about rickets, so it is also same as it is osteomalacia. But if children and if child affect by the that particular problem, so that condition we call that thing is rickets. But if adult is caused by and if adult is occur by this kind of problem, so that condition we call osteomalacia. Okay, but problem is same thing in a ricket condition, in a osteomalacia condition, both condition. Okay, now definition about osteomalacia. So is a rare condition of adult bone associated with vitamin D deficiency, resulting in the decalcification and softening of the bone. So what is actual happen in duration of osteomalacia? So in a condition of osteomalacia, basically decalcification of occurred, and then after maybe the chances is softening of the bone in a duration of osteomalacia period. Okay, it is called osteomalacia. Now here have some etiology about the osteomalacia. First etiology is lack of exposure to ultraviolet rays, means vitamin D rays. If deficiency of vitamin D, because we all are know in vitamin D means sunlight, in a comes under to sunlight, there is available of ultraviolet rays. So if person have a deficiency or and a lack of exposure of ultraviolet or vitamin D, that condition, that problem, that person have a risk for the osteomalacia. GI malabsorption. If person have a problem GI malabsorption, GI means gastrointestinal malabsorption, so that condition also. Extensive burns, if person have extensive sunburn problem, so that condition, that person also have a risk for the osteomalacia. Chronic diarrhea, if person have a chronic diarrhea problem, so that condition, that person vitamin D is not properly absorbed. Okay, so that condition, that person also have a risk for the osteomalacia. Some condition, pregnancy also one kind of risk for the osteomalacia. And kidney disease means renal problem also one kind of reason for osteomalacia also. And then drugs such as the phenytoin means anticonvulsant drugs. So this kind of thing is also one kind of responsible factor for the condition of osteomalacia. Okay, now next thing about osteomalacia is pathophysiology. So firstly, due to any kind of etiological factor, like etiology factor is a lack of the vitamin D or insufficient vitamin D intake, it is one kind of reason for osteomalacia. Then further, which lead to the interfere with normal mineralization of the bone. If person is not proper taking of vitamin D, that condition what happen? Interference of the mineralization of bone. Then further, which lead to the failure or insufficient calcification of the bone, because do not proper mineralization of the bone. Okay, so if person is have a problem decalcification of the bone, that condition, that person definitely have a chance for the bone softening. Okay, because we all are know calcium is have a very major source for the maintaining of strengthening of the bone. So that condition, if person have a insufficiency of calcification, so person maybe the chances gone for the condition of bone softening. And we all are know if person have a softening of bone, that condition we call that particular situation is osteomalacia. Okay, so it is a related to osteomalacia pathophysiology. I hope you all are understand. Now we will see some symptoms related to osteomalacia. Here have a lots of symptoms related to osteomalacia. First is localized bone pain. Okay, मीन्स विच एरिया बोन इज अफेक्टेड, दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया बोन हैव अ सेंसेशन ऑफ पेन फील बाय दैट पर्टिकुलर सफरिंग पर्सन, एंड डिफिकल्टी राइजिंग फ्रॉम अ चेयर, एंड डिफिकल्टी वॉकिंग ऑल्सो हैपन जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ बोथ थिंग इज कम्स अंडर टू मूवमेंट मूवमेंट फंक्शन, एंड इफ पर्सन हैव अ प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू बोन दैट कंडीशन दैट पर्सन डेफिनेटली मूवमेंट प्रॉब्लम अकर. ओके, लो बैक एंड बोन पेन, लो बैक पेन जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ वीकनेस ऑफ बोन, दैट्स वाई वेट लॉस बिकॉज नॉट प्रॉपर ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ बोन जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द वीकनिंग एंड and losing of the bone. So it is also one kind of symptom for the condition of osteomalacia. Now next symptom is progressive muscular weakness. Okay, so if person is suffered by the osteomalacia, that condition affect bone as well as with the bone affecting muscles, that particular area also affected. So it is also one kind of symptoms. Progressive deformities of the spine, it is called nephrosis or extremities. Okay, if person is suffer by any area osteomalacia bones, that condition that person have a chance for deformity of the spine bone also, just because of spine is a supporting ligament for another part of the bone. Okay, now the fracture are common and demonstrate delayed healing full day occurs. Means if a person have a day by day weakening and day by day softening of the bone, that condition that person definitely have a major chance for the fracture. Okay, so it is also one kind of symptoms for the condition of osteomalacia. So this all are comes under two clinical feature about osteomalacia. Now the diagnostic measures, here have some diagnostic evaluation for the detected condition of osteomalacia. So first important diagnostic evaluation is history taking and history collection. It is very common for each and every condition. And physical examination, it is also very important kind of diagnostic measures for the detect the patient related to osteomalacia, because I already told you lots of time, history is help for detect the condition of cause and physical examination help to detect the symptoms. Okay, so that is the reason behind both things, we perform both kind of thing in a comes under two diagnostic measures. Okay student, now the next investigation is blood study. Which kind of blood study is very very important measures, like decrease serum calcium and phosphorus levels, means calcium serum and phosphorus serum is very very important kind of diagnostic parameter tools. Decrease serum 25 hydroxy vitamin D, means vitamin D is also very important kind of parameter investigation tool, because we all are know very important kind of factor for the osteomalacia is the vitamin D deficiency. That's why it is very very important kind of investigation tool. Okay, to monitor vitamin D. Then evaluate serum alkaline phosphate, so it is also comes under two blood study and parameter for the blood study for the detection to condition of osteomalacia. Now the next imaging investigation is X-ray, CT scan and MRI. That three thing is comes under two imaging investigation, and that particular thing is help for detect the condition of location site of the affected part. Okay, so this kind of thing is comes under two diagnostic measures for the condition of osteomalacia. Okay students, now we will see treatment option, treatment therapy for osteomalacia. Okay, here have some also investigation thing before going to in management. Once again we will see investigation. CBC means complete blood count, means blood study. Electrolyte is very important, and level of calcium it is very important, phosphorus it is very important, and calcium phosphorus index also very important, vitamin D and ALF PTH. So that particular kind is comes under to blood investigation, and it is very very important investigation tool for the detection the condition of osteomalacia. Okay, now we will see management correct for the osteomalacia. So here have some management options for the condition of osteomalacia. So first important management for the osteomalacia is correction of vitamin D deficiency, because our major factor for osteomalacia is vitamin D. So if we are proper correction of vitamin D deficiency, that condition we are definitely capable for treat the condition of osteomalacia. Okay, so first important treatment is osteomalacia is osteomalacia vitamin D. Now the second, vitamin D3 calcification calciferol and vitamin D2 ergocalciferol can be the supplemented for the correction of vitamin D. And then second, calcium salt or phosphorus supplement can be prescribed for the maintaining of strengthening of the bone. And dietary injection of egg, low fat, milk, fish and vegetables is encouraged for the proper maintenance of strength density of the bone. And if we maintain the proper strength level of the bone, that condition, that person definitely no having a chance losing of the bone. Okay, so proper injection of the dietary factors, we are encouraged to the patient proper take the diet proper time. Then the exposure to sunlight, so it is very very important and very very major source for vitamin D. Okay, so we are encouraged to patient proper take sunlight for the maintaining of vitamin D and correction of vitamin D deficiency. So this kind of treatment is very important treatment for the condition of osteomalacia. Now let's think. Here have some primary investigation and primary management. So primary prevention for the osteomalacia is adequate and sun exposure. It is very primary prevention for the osteomalacia. If we proper maintain sunlight and if we proper maintain vitamin D, that condition we are not have a risk for the osteomalacia. Okay. Now then next thing is diet rich in calcium. It is also help for the bone function process. Treatment of underlying condition diseases, means if person suffer any other kind of musculoskeletal problem, that condition if we are proper treating that problem, so that condition we don't have any risk for the osteomalacia. So this all thing is comes under to primary prevention for the condition of osteomalacia. Now pharmacological treatment also available for the condition of osteomalacia, like nutritional osteomalacia respond well to administer of 10,000 IU weekly of vitamin D for 4 to 6 weeks, vitamin D medicine for the condition of correction of vitamin D deficiency weekly 4 to 6 weeks basically. Okay, per weekly means OD. And osteomalacia due to the malabsorption may require treatment by injection or oral dosing of significant amount of vitamin D. And calcium as phosphorus supplement drugs also we prescribe the patient related to osteomalacia. So basically here three kind of medicine is help for treatment of the osteomalacia. First medicine is vitamin D medicines, second calcium supplements medicine, and phosphorus supplements medicines. So these three kind of medicine is help for treatment of osteomalacia condition. Okay, so it is comes under to pharmacological treatment. Now here have some complication related to osteomalacia. If we are not proper treated osteomalacia, that condition have a chance this particular kind of complication. So first, respiratory problems, infection or atelectasis due to the chest deformities. Okay, now the GIT constipation means by the malabsorption GIT also happen, and bony deformities or fractures sometime happen just because of the softening of bone, and anemia also happen due to the chronic infection or deficiency. Because why anemia happen? Because we all are know our bone marrow is help for the production of red blood cell. So here if person is suffer by osteomalacia, that condition definitely have a chance to alteration of bone marrow function. So that's why the reason anemia also happen just by the osteomalacia condition. Okay student, so it is comes under to complication for the osteomalacia condition. Okay, So here our topic related to osteomalacia completed. Thank you everyone for listening me. I hope you all are understand about the osteomalacia. It is very small topic. And if you have any doubt, so please ask me.